Okay, class, let's get started on part six. So this will be the path animation, and we're going to add a little bit of shape key animation here to blink the eyes and to how to cycle. All right, so first let's do the motion path. Okay, basically our character will follow a curved path, but we're going to add a parent to the hip, so that the hip is still independent. We can still, we can do a running jump and all that stuff. We're not doing NLA, nonlinear animation, for this lesson, but the idea is to prepare yourself now using helpers or empties so that you can accomplish multiple things to the children of those helpers, okay? So let's adjust this a little bit, all right? And then I'm gonna go to the, I'm gonna expand our, put a selectability here. All right, let's see. All right, where's our floor? Okay, so there's the floor. I'm gonna select it. I'm gonna expand this because our character is gonna run around. Okay, and lighting's probably not gonna be optimal now because this guy's gonna be moving. So let me see if we turn off that. Okay, backlighting still works. Area light. Let's see. We might need to. I'm just gonna move it right here. There we go. There's the area light. Probably move that all the way to the back. Okay, and then just crank that up. Maybe 2,000 watts. 5,000 watts. Okay, just so that, because we're going to be moving about. Let's see here, this guy. Alright. Just so that, we got all those kind of covered. All right, so now we can hide those back and we can get started with the lesson here. Lights, there we go. Okay, all right, so our character, let's add a helper. So empty circle right there, RX90. Turn on screencast so you can see what I'm typing. All right, so, and then we'll move this, right, well, you know, the hip location right there, okay? And it will accumulate some numbers right here, so what we want to do with this one is just so that to keep everything tidy, all deltas, so it's all, okay? And we're going to name this one. This is a controller, so CTRL character, okay? Controller character. So we're gonna select the hip, shift click that empty right there, control P, object. So when we grab the object, the floor, unselect, there you go, there we go. So now we can move our character. I mean, we could still do that because we have the at least we can rotate, like, let's say R, Y. Yeah, we're gonna go global now because it's just flat. We're not worried about those angled, weird angle rotation. So we can still do this, even though we can pivot. All right. So now nothing has changed. That one just got added. But here's what we're gonna do now. Let's create a path. Okay. So curve. Add curve path right here. So it start off fairly small. I'm gonna click edit. Okay. And let's say we want to start, that's the beginning right there. And we're just going to kind of expand this thing for our character to kind of traverse and follow. Okay. Then what we want to do is select the, let's move this up first so that it's the same level as our parent, which is a body controller. So I'm gonna go 1. Okay, and it's kind of lower that, kind of highball, just so that everything is nicely positioned, okay? Select the parent, the control character, shift click the curve, okay? Which is the NURBS path, okay? And then we're gonna go control P, and we're gonna do follow path. All right, so what's gonna happen is the character is gonna follow that path right there. All right, so if we make our animation to 250 frames long, it's gonna follow that for 250 frames. Okay, it's not doing so well because we don't have any cycled animation. Even though we call it cycle animation before, we were only watching it through a loop, okay? So there was a loop on the playback, which gives it, you know, that kind of, it's a cycle, but it's not really cycled. So, and this is what happens when you do that, okay? But let's position the character first, okay? So let's move this one right there. So I'm just kind of eyeballing the, let's go to wireframe. So the dot at the very beginning of that path, right there, so that it follows it, okay? The other thing also is when we select the NURBS path, we can go to its parameters right here. If we click on clamp, clamp says curve path children's, clamp them so that they don't travel past the start and end point. So we do want that. So they can't go at the, you know, past the beginning of that one. Okay, and then when you have follow check, it follows the orientation of the curve, right? So when it's unchecked, this guy would be looking like it's gliding and whatnot. All right. Actually, we have it reverse with the when I moved there. So, but when you click on follow, it just follows the orientation. There you go. So you want follow check, and that's what that means. Okay. So now we don't know yet how well it's sliding and whatnot, because it's hard to preview because we are not cycling. So let's cycle first. Okay. So let's turn on our. Okay, let's select all the objects here that need cycling. So definitely that foot, I mean that leg right there, the other leg, the hip for sure, the body, everything we set up for part four. Okay, okay, just the Lego character, right? None of the parent, which is the empty, and the pattern, of course, the floor. All right, so here, very important. We can go to our dope sheet right here, okay? Or we can go to our function curve so you can actually see it, okay? So let's go to our function curve here, graph editor, okay? I'm gonna select everything in here. It looks messy, so tilde frame all, there it is. But as you can see, past 19, there's no activity, okay? So if you happen to open this one, press N to like a little sidebar for the graph editor. While you have everything selected, the keys that you want to cycle, you can select the, where are we here? The modifier, okay? Let's look at the modifier. And then we want to add a modifier cycles. So when you click on cycles, everything is selected first, object selected, right? You press A right here to select all the keyframes. Add modifier cycles, okay? And right here, you can already tell that even at the beginning, even if we go negative frames, it will still repeat the motion. There it is. And the reason why this is successful is that very similar to your Pixar animation that you did in basic animation and 3D animation one, basic animation is that we're doing this because it's happening because it's divisible, right? 15. All the keys right here are repeating in 15 frames, okay? So if your arm swing is only 12 frames, you got to make sure that it's 14 by adding two extra frames of non-movement or movement, just so that everything cycles. Because if the body is cycling at 15 frames and then the hip is at 17, then that's not going to match. You're going to have some twitching, all right? So now let's take a look. Now that we added cycles, so add modifier cycles, there it is. So it's forever now wanting to run, okay? But we ran out of path. Okay, so now at least we got that set. All right, so now let's go to our shape key. Now that we're at this topic of cycles, okay? So let's go to the front. Okay, so I'm going to select just the head right here. And this is something new if you haven't done shape keys yet. Okay, so make sure you select the shape, the head in the front viewport right here. Make sure it's kind of flat. Okay, because you're going to, we're going to cheat here and just move some lines. Okay, and what we want to do here is go to edit mode. Okay, and I want to isolate just the eye right here with the Control R or the loop cut. Okay, so I'm going to do Control R, and perfectly right there below the eye is where I want to park that loop cut. Okay, when you do that, okay, you have this option right here, so you can do correct UVs. Okay, so what's happening is that when I do another Control R right here, and then you try to move it, it's doing all that, it's not correcting it. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to do correct UV so that when you move them down, it's supposed to correct the UVs. Hold on. Okay, so Control R. Okay. All right, so you can't slide this because once you have correct UVs on, it's supposed to be off. And then you turn those on so that it just, you know, it doesn't displace them. So we'll do another one right here. Okay, we'll add one. And then we can go like so. When we lower it down, it, okay, there you go. It squashes it, and then you click on correct UVs. Then they're set. Okay, so that's my mistake right there. Okay, so you can see the correct UVs, because once you move them, that's when you start seeing those. Okay, so I should have marked where those are supposed to be. So let me click undo. Okay, right here where the eye is. Okay, let's see. Here we go. Now that we have correct UVs on, none got distorted right there. So the whole idea here is, well, we're done with that one. Is if I select all these points right here and then I go move down, we kind of have like a cheap eye blink. Okay, well, we need another line right here because it looks like the eye, we don't want the eyebrow getting distorted. Okay, and I select this one. All right, there's our fake eye blink. Okay, all right, so now that we did three cuts, and just kind of rewatch the video where I messed up, where, you know, the correct UV is not click, otherwise you can't move those things down. Okay, we're going to go here to our shape key. So the shape key is this data tab, where it looks like a three vertices green triangle. Okay, you have to be in object mode when you do this. So shape key is what we want. So we click plus sign first. So when you click plus sign, this is the original shape or non-deformed or non-move vertices version of the head. So you always need one. It's called basis, right? That's where it referred it back to when you have no value. We're going to click plus again. There's our first key. Okay, so we're going to call this one eye blink. Okay, so what it is that once I go to edit mode and I grab those points, okay, and I move them down while the eye blink is selected right there. So maybe right there. Okay. Okay. And then when we go to object mode, you don't see it because it's going to the basis right there. But if I have this eye blink in object mode, I now have this value that I can animate, and then I can close those eyes. All right. So we want them to blink. So let's go, let's say on frame 10. Is when he starts blinking. So we go value 0, no blink. Okay, and then we'll do a blink probably four frames right there. We go close the eyes, keyframe it, and then maybe in 3 frames open them up. Okay, so now we take a look. there you go. All right, so we have, we want that to repeat, okay? So let's switch to our dope sheet right here. So this is the eye blink. So we have it on 10. All right, so we want this to kind of repeat. All right, so on frame 10, let's put a no blink value keyframe. Again, remember, you want, if I don't put another, if I didn't put a padding keyframe there on one, it's just going to keep blinking nonstop. Okay, 10 and, well, let's see, you know, let's kind of do that. All right, so I'm going to select it. Okay, it's the blink. Remember, we did the same thing in the graph editor here. Press A. Modifier cycles. Did we have? What was the error? Did I miss it? Okay, let me go to dope sheet right here so I know for sure those are the only thing kind of selected. Okay, then Shift E. Okay, Shift E is the shortcut, make cyclic. All right, so look, it's blinking nonstop, because we only have three keyframes. So if we want it to blink from one, okay, frame one, no blinking, okay, then we go to 10, and then let's say, how frequent is the blink? Let's say frame 30, okay, we add another no blink. So from 1 to 30, we have no blink, okay, and then finally blink here, and then no blink, and then after 30, oh, did it start blinking also again? Where did I messed up? Okay, so what I should have done is, all right, because I applied blink before I added those keyframes, so I got to redo it. Okay, so select it, Shift E, because I was trying to show an example. Let me click undo here. Let's not add the blink until let's not add the cycle until we keyframe. All right, so right here on frame one, now that you understand it, okay, and then on frame 30, no blink. All right, so now once we select all those, okay, we can then Shift E, make cyclic. So no blink, blink, no blink, and then we follow this, no blink 30, and then we have 10 frames right here. So 40, it's going to repeat. So this whole section is going to repeat here. So 40 is when we start to see the beginning of the blink. No? It didn't blink. Why come? Okay. What did I miss? Okay. Just the key. All right, let's just select the key right there. All right, just the key. Shift E. Oh, there you go. All right, so I don't know. I must have missed it, but so make sure you highlight it first. It turns green. Then you select the keys. Then you go Shift E, make cyclic. And then there it is. All right. All right, so it's blinking. Okay, so now what else do we need to do? So the path right here, it's not very long. Okay, we set it to 250 frames, and we're basically by frame 100, it's already done. All right, so we want to extend this one. So hit Tab, select one of the endpoints right there, and press E. Okay, so I'm extending the, don't worry, it's following it because I didn't set the evaluation time to 250 frames. Can I just join that? Hold on. Right here. Press F. All right. That's a hard, because it's not as Bezier. Let's see. Okay. So evaluation time, 250 frames. Okay, it did not like that I connected that one. All right, so right there, let's go 250 right here. Oh, sorry. Okay, so it's 250 now, so. All right, so what's happening is that it's it's pulling it way too fast for its so we need longer animation for the amount of path that I created. So let's say 500 frames, and we go 500 frames. Okay, let's see. So oh, okay, I messed up. I put valuation time instead of frames. Okay. Alright, my mistake. Okay, 250. That's, I keep putting, okay. Good thing you can rewind my mistakes. Alright, so we're gonna add. Let's see, because if you make this too much of a path, then it looks like it's sliding. Actually, that's super slow right there. There's a, well, actually, not. It's not so bad. Let's see here. Yeah, there's definitely some sliding involved. All right, so we can extend it some more. Again, this is forward kinematic, so a lot of it is we're kind of timing it manually. Probably a little too much, so I'm going to reduce it right there. Okay, let's take a look. All right, that's not bad. Especially this is supposed to be kind of like the semi-run or brisk walking. Okay, so let's go to our 3D full view right here, or we can go to our layout. Okay, let's go to our layout and let's turn off our helpers right there. Let's turn back the lights. That light is way too hot right there, the one I put at 5000. Let's see. Let me just lower that. 3000. Oh. Alright. And let's see, our character kind of just walk around here or run around. Could be a performance thing too. Let's see if it's walking a lot faster in. Oh, yeah. All right, so definitely path design is very important. You don't want to skimp out on finding this line right here. You don't want crazy sharp turns like what I did here, because it forces your character to pivot unnaturally, being a Lego character right there. So try to kind of mitigate those lines a little bit, and then make it a little bit more less of a sharp turn. Okay, cover, and I'm trying to even out my points right here so there's no sliding. Their distance, I'm trying to even them out. Okay, all right, I think that's good enough right there. So where did I mess up? Shape key, the cycle. All right, so just kind of keep that in mind. When I did the cycle on that one, I did not click the shape key. All right, I did not turn that green right there, I think, and then select those points, shift E makes I click. Okay, all right, and I think this will do for the motion path. All right. All right, so if you're doing this for homework, just make sure you set to 250, make a quick time render, add cameras, lights, and floor, and then make your path, make your character walk, okay? And then make sure it is a quick time movie when you output, all right? Quick time movie encoding right there, quick time. All right, 250 frames, export this out, add lights, all that kind of stuff. You can even put obstacle course right here. You can put, you can make this path go up. Okay, so you can put a ramp if you want to. See that? So you can put a bridge right there if you want. Okay, and yeah, this is how you actually animate cars too, if you want to put it on a path and whatnot. So that should cover the lesson, and thanks for watching.